Hello children, welcome to our computer class. Today we are going to see lesson 2, types of software. Dear children, in our last class we have studied about types of computer memory and some storage devices, right? Primary memory and secondary memory are the two types of computer memory. Hardware comes under the internal storage device. CD, DVD, pen drive and memory card comes under the external storage devices. Children, come to the lesson. Take page number 12, types of software. Hardware and software are the two important elements of a computer system. Hardware refers to the physical components of a computer that can be seen and touched. Software is a set of programs or instructions that makes the computer to do specific task. Children, you play games on a computer. A game is an example of a software, and things such as the mouse, keyboard, monitor and joystick with which you play the game are examples of hardware. Okay, children, now let's see the two types of software. System software and application software. The system software are further subdivided into the three types: operating system, language translator and utility software. And application software are further subdivided into the two types: general purpose and the special purpose. Now let's see system software. System software is a software that controls the entire operation of the computer. It has an overall control on the hardware. System software is a very important part of a computer system. Without a system software, the computer is like a car without a driver. Operating system. Operating system is a part of system software. An operating system control and coordinate the overall activities of a computer. It acts as a mediator between the user and the computer system. See children, operating system is a software that helps you to operate the computer system through its various functions. It control and manage the different part of the computer system. It acts as an interface between the user and the computer system. There are the different operating systems. Some of the popular operating systems are MS-DOS, MS-Windows and Linux. Important functions of operating system are file management, device management, memory management, controls and runs the software, handles input and output, security. Next one, language translator. A language translator is a system software that converts programs written in programming language into computer readable language of zeros and ones. Children, the system knows only zeros and ones. The task of the translator is to convert the programming language into the computer language. The examples of language translators are assembler, compiler and interpreter. Assembler convert the programs written in assembly language to machine language. Compiler convert the programs written in high level language to machine level language as a whole. Interpreter converts the programs written in high-level language to machine-level language line by line. Utility software. Utility software is a system software. It helps in maintaining a computer. It helps to analyze and monitor the performance and proper functions of a computer. Examples of utility software are antivirus software. It helps to protect our computer and network from virus. What is virus? Virus is nothing but virus is a program that causes damage to data and files on a system. Examples of antivirus softwares are McAfee, Symantec, AVG. Backup software. Backup is a procedure that copies data to an alternative location for recovery. It protects data from corruption and changes. Backup can be done on storage devices and servers. Here you can see some pictures: CD, DVD, cloud servers and pen drive. These are the examples of backup devices. Compression utility. It is a software program. Large files can be compressed in small size file, attached and sent through the email. Examples of compression utility is WinRAR. Okay, children. Now let's see the application software. The software is a collection of programs designed to do specific task on the computer. Children, have you noticed the wall clock at your home? What does it do? It does only one thing. It shows the time, right? Similarly, the application software is a software that helps you in doing some specific work. Okay. For example, you use the paint program to draw. You cannot do some using paint. Okay. If you want to do sums, you use the calculator program, right? Okay. There are the two categories of application software. They are general purpose application software and special purpose application software. General purpose application software. This software is designed to meet the general needs of a user. Some common examples of general purpose application software are word processing software, spreadsheet software, multimedia software, presentation software and graphics software. Children, now let's see one by one. The first one is a word processing software. A word processor is an application software. This software helps the user to create and edit the documents. There are many word processing software available. Some of them are Microsoft Word and Notepad and WordPad are the examples of word processing software. A word processor is used by the different people to do the different kind of work. For teacher making a timetable, for business people making a business report, and for student for typing an essay or a letter. The next one is a spreadsheet software. This software helps the user to perform calculations and organizing the numerical data in the form of charts for further analysis. Examples of spreadsheet software are MS Excel, Lotus 1-2-3, and Apple numbers are the examples of spreadsheet software. Like the supermarket and the textile shop, using the spreadsheet software for calculations and maintaining their accounts. The next one is a multimedia software. The software allows the user to create and play audio and video files. Examples of multimedia softwares are Windows Media Player, Real Player and VLC Player. Film industry is using this software for audio video editing and sound effects and graphics, and many more sub departments are using the multimedia software. Next one is a presentation software. The software shows the information in the form of slides. So examples of presentation softwares are Adobe Flash, MS PowerPoint and OpenOffice Impress. Presentation software is now widely used for teaching. This video also made in MS PowerPoint. Next one is a graphics software. It allows us to create, manipulate or model images on a computer like cartoons, logos, etc. Examples of graphics softwares are MS Paint, Adobe Photoshop, Dreamweaver. Okay children, now let us revise today's concept. Hardware and software are two important elements of a computer system. The two types of software are system software and application software. System software controls the entire operation of a computer. Application software is the collection of programs. Dear children, hope you have understood today's concept. Thank you.